Who is this mysterious stranger? So this level takes a little bit of a weird turn. Because you have all these turtles everywhere. And there's still all the fish eggs, which... to me, it's kind of weird. Makes me rethink what this entire stage is built on, because like up here, it's like, okay, it looks like crystals. They're just forming like platforms or whatever. A skyscraper of crystals. Okay, whatever. That's fine. Almost killed myself there. But when you get down there and you think like, okay, underground was like a bunch of like flickering crystal blocks and fish eggs that you would shoot and fish would come out. Right? And that would make, like, the bulk of the platforms down there. And, you know, besides looking very similar, suspiciously similar to Flashman's stage, you think, okay, well, what are these things? I mean, it's fucking... everything's flickering and lighting up. I don't know what the hell all this stuff is supposed to be. But I'm sure it's not normal. I'm sure you can't find this stuff at Home Depot. So you take a few more steps, and you see like some of these things that have, some of these blocks, these flashing blocks, that have cracks in them. And like the fucking little baby turtles are coming out of it. So apparently, Gemini Man lives in a giant fish hatchery. And that's just his thing. What does that have to do with Gemini? I don't even know. I have no idea what's going on. None of it makes sense. But it's a pretty cool stage. I like the colors. So like Flashman stage, except way better. So pull out the Shadow Blades again. Pick up a whale in this guy. Which, speaking of Flashman, there he is. And he's... I don't think this is his weakness, but whatever. I'm gonna go with it. Just wail on him and hope I kill him. Which is the best strategy of all strategies. I'm gonna wail on you and hope you die. I think if you'd hit me one more time, I'd have been dead. So that was a close call. I think I could survive this horrific nightmare. I just gotta keep plugging away. So let's see, here's what I'm talking about. See, the little thing is cracked and there's like little baby turtles coming out. Now, once again, I gotta use another brush machine. It's required for me to use it to survive. Which is cool. Otherwise, I wouldn't use this piece of shit Rush Marine because there's no water in this goddamn game. Ah. Took it in the face. But you would think, okay, like, you're inside the Rush Marine, and, like, he's completely got you covered. So, like, you'd think it would be like an Mega Man X, where you're in the ride armor, and every time you got hit, you didn't take damage, but the ride armor took damage. So wouldn't Rush take damage, and then it would just make, like, his energy drop or something, you know? Like, that's the mechanic they use for Beat in Mega Man 5, where his energy only runs out when he does damage to someone else. But I don't know. I don't design Mega Man games. What do I know? There's more of these crazy turtles. Why did I go up there? And now we're underwater. Guess what this means? You know who I'm fighting next. That's right. Fucking Bubble Man. Oops. That was totally unintentional. So now that I got my life back, I'm gonna pull out something to kill this guy with. But it makes sense that sparks will work. I'm gonna fucking wail in this asshole. I don't think it's his weakness, but fuck it, I'm gonna use it. It's good enough. Oh man, it's such a pushover anyway. Fucking strong breeze would kill him, which is why he lives in the water. He's afraid of air. Now we come to the last stage. Another mysterious stranger has emerged. So what does this stage have in store for me? It looks like a lot more spikes. And more of these guys. There's gonna be a lot more darkness puzzles. Which are okay, I guess. You can bypass a lot of them. Instead of Proto Man, I gotta fight this big ass fucking douchebag. I don't wanna die! I didn't have to kill him, I could have just ran, but fuck it. He started it. Now, this area is like way more open than it used to be. But it's about to get more complicated with a bunch of these crazy jump platforms. Which I fucking hate. Because they disappear as soon as you touch them, so you have to like wail on the jump button. And I could jump across and risk it. But fuck it. I'm not gonna risk getting killed instantly by fucking stupid jump puzzles. I'm gonna do this the manly way. With ingenuity. I'll take care of these fucking walking grenades. Oh, you asshole. Which, who thought that was a good idea? Like, it was smart. Let's design, what kind of robots are we gonna use? Let's make some walking grenades. That should be fine. Which I guess I can't blame him because, I mean, Mario did do it first. At least I think he did. So, yeah. You can blame it on inspiration. And once again, we come to Woodman, who is the most sexually ambiguous of all robots. And once again, dodging his shit is still really hard. And some people say it's not that hard, but it's still really fucking hard to me. I don't know why. I can never jump over it. And because I'm too lazy, I'm gonna fucking keep using these needles, because I'll never need them again anyway. And they go even faster than the regular shooting buster, except you don't have to keep shooting him. You just hold the button and it shoots automatically. Just an automatic win. I don't even know why they have these spikes in the ceiling. How are you supposed to get up there anyway? Why would you go up there in the first place? It's not like an underwater stage where like you jump up and you would hit the ceiling and you have to keep, you know, avoiding it like Bubble Man stage, but I don't know. I didn't make this game, I don't know. I don't know what they were thinking. Maybe they intended there to be water here. But then why would there be paratroopers? They'd be swimmers. I don't know. I don't know. Whatever. Recharge my needles, which I'm not even gonna use. Pull out some blades, take care of this dumbass. And now we come to the last of all Mega Man 2 bosses. You know who it is. It's Zippo Lighter Man, who can apparently walk. Even with the fucking dash attack, it's still really hard to dodge that first goddamn thing. I don't think I'm gonna kill this guy. I think he's gonna kill me. Yep. Fuck. That's my first legit death. I'm calling it. I just sat there and took it, but no, I tried. Round 2. Yeah, I don't know what the fuck. There's a way you could do it, but I'm stupid. Come on, man. You get hit by everything. This guy's relentless. Which is nothing else, it makes this match way harder than Mega Man 2, because he died in 3 hits in Mega Man 2. So, yeah. And now that I destroyed everything else, I gotta fight the elusive Break Man. Who apparently, I don't know if this is supposed to be Proto Man, or if it's supposed to be an imposter Proto Man, I think it's the Imposter Proto Man. I don't know. I have no idea what the fuck this game is trying to tell me. But luckily, unlike the other matches against Proto Man, I don't have to beat a whole stage first. Oh shit, bring out the money for the cutscenes. Right after we received the last element, Wily ran off with Gamma. He stole the robot we were building together, with grant money from the government. And the best sound effect of all Mega Man sound effects, this fucking annoying ass beeping sound that will permanently burn into my brain. And somehow, even though it's been months since I destroyed his last castle, he has a new one. Where does he get his money? I'm thinking that the only possible way that he could be getting his money while to do this stuff, because like most scientists, well, you know, they have to get like grants, and they'll get those from the government or investors or something like that, and that'll be their living, and they'll develop technology for the world. But no one's gonna trust anything that Wily builds, because Wily just wants to control the world with evil fighting robots. And he does it like every year. He comes back with more robots. And he's like, I'm gonna do it again. And it's like, where did I destroyed your castle last year. How did you build a new one? And so I think he's gotta be getting his money from organized crime. Like the Joker. I think he's like a mob boss. And he's just using the money to build extravagant castles filled with robots. Because that's what gets him off. So, that's my theory. I'm sticking with it. And I'm going to use this, which isn't high enough to reach that top level. I'm going to recharge my knuckles. I'm totally going to need these things later. Not quite pull out the jet. Get this E-Tank I'm not going to use. How many do I have? I got 7 already. Yeah, I'm not going to use it. I'm going to use like 2 for the rest of the game. Maybe. But I got 7. I'm going to keep collecting them because I like them. I like the sound effect. You know, that's why like I use it to click the lives because I don't need those either. And they're usually more tucked out of the way than the E-Tanks are. But goddammit, like I see them and it's like, I forgot to collect them. I can't help myself. Even if this is supposed to be like a speedrun, which it's not really. I'm just playing the game. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm gonna kill him. No. Which is why this weapon's so awesome. It's omnidirectional, which makes it the best weapon. But it's not as good as the... Oh, fuck you. Incompetence. Which makes it not as overpowered as the last... fucking rush, the last fucking metal weapon, because, you know, does it kill everything in 1 or 2 hits, and it doesn't fly completely off the screen. You can only use it for a very small radius. That's what's called video game balance. Guess I recharge this, even though I don't really need to yet. Now I'm gonna fight a boss. Everyone knows the turtle dispenser. Yeah. I don't know if this enemy has a weakness or not. I don't really care because those things die in like 2 shots anyway. Fuck you. I don't know if this would be harder or not as hard if the little wind things didn't blow you around and just did damage. Either way, this... boss is like stupid easy. He don't even give a fuck. He's just begging to die. Level 2. And now here's the annoying part. That'll probably be the only time you'll ever see those jumping things again. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I think. At least anything that can't be bypassed. And a perfect spot for these things. Oh, this is the level I fucking hate. There's more of these bees. But you could totally just fucking outrun most of them. you can actually kill them because you're up here to shoot them. Or at least most of them you are. So I'm gonna go down here. It's like a decoy. That guy's an asshole. It's like you don't really need the jet to do everything you did, like in the Needleman stage I was in. But I'm gonna do it anyway. Because it's just easier that way. Now what is this? This is like my ninth E-Tank. Totally don't need anymore, but I'm still gonna keep collecting them just cause I can. This is everyone's favorite, kind of ridiculous boss. Is the Yellow Devil. He's in a lot of Mega Man games. And at first you saw this guy and you're like, oh, what the fuck? I don't know where he's at. I don't see anything. And then you get fucking blasted from the side of the screen when a fucking block hits you in the face. And then you notice, okay, he's building this thing. Alright, I see what's going on. Only problem is, you only got like a second to shoot him once while he's shooting at you. And, I'm totally not using the right weapon on this guy. So, I think it's this one. Probably should have fact checked this shit. Here we go. Shoot him in the eye. There you go. Alright. Every now and then, just piss you off, he fucking changes direction like that. That was bullshit. You saw he should have died. But this guy is nothing but bullshit. So I gotta wait for him to finish this animation until I can hit him a third time. I'm gonna be dead. I never have to think about him again until one of the other Mega Man's reap. Aw, really? One? This guy's an asshole. He's a professional asshole. Yellow Devil is like the Dennis Leary of Mega Man 2 bosses. All Mega Man bosses. Level 3. This is where shit starts getting real. And the music changes, and this actually is like pretty damn good Wily stage music. So now I gotta pick a side. I'm gonna go up this side. I know there's stuff here, and I need Hard Knuckle, so I'm gonna do this. Recharge all my knuckles. I have replenished my knuckle. Another E-Tank, which I totally don't need, but I don't have a maxed out number of 9, so I'm totally gonna grab it. Waste everybody's time. And now we march on, fight these fucking grenades that walk. There's nothing complicated going on here. I'll get it, whatever. Fine. I won't need it. But fuck it, I don't give a shit. It was there, it was beckoning. Ah, come on. So now a light suddenly turns on, and yay. Alright, I gotta kill these guys. Nope. I fucking hate the item management system in this game. And eventually they fixed it in Mega Man 4. Was just all one clean screen. That was a completely different transition. This is pretty cool. Some little sliding jumping puzzles that lead right to your death if you mess them up. And a few more, just in case you didn't have enough in the first screen. Because I never like to do anything just once. I mean, why build a mechanic to use just once? That'd be stupid. Let's see. Probably won't need any of the stuff that's here. But let's see what it is. Oh, hell, that's pretty good. Alright. That was worth it, I guess. Oh shit, what's this? More Mega Man clones? Basically, this is just like the fight that you had in the last Mega Man game. But except now, there's 3 of them. And you don't know which one's the real one until you shoot it. They can all damage you, but you can't all damage them. I don't really have a weakness, but as you can see, I just wailed on him like a fucking psychopath, and he died in like 2 seconds.